Welcome to another episode of BSA Lab. For today's episode, we will be doing the watercolor effect. Let us start by creating a new Photoshop file. Set the size to 800 by 1067 pixels. Now here I have the model's picture. Now I will use the Magic Wand tool to remove the background and transfer the model's picture using the Move tool. Now I have here two watercolor paper textures, both of which you can download from the link attached together with other textures and photos to be used for this tutorial. For these textures, you need to adjust both of their opacities to 30%, and then you need to transfer them to the background of our current canvas together with the model's picture. As for the second paper texture, I will move its hue and saturation to change its color to a more greenish tone. Adjust the color until you see or achieve something similar to this one. Now remember to place the model's layer on top of both of the paper textures. We'll now start blending in the model with the paper textures or the background using the eraser tool. I will choose a brush that has an opacity of around 20 to 40% for a more faded effect. I will erase around the outline of the model so that she blends in even more in the background. Like so. After which, I will adjust the hue or saturation of the model to give her a more greenish effect. Now I have here a watercolor texture that can be downloaded together with the other pictures to be used for this tutorial. I'll transfer it to the model's Photoshop file and change the layer setting into Multipack. Adjust the image until you're satisfied with the placement. You can even duplicate it to achieve a fuller look in her hair. Now I'll use the eraser tool with a weak opacity of around 20-30% to erase unwanted parts of the watercolor splatter that I've used in this model's head. Same goes for the second watercolor texture. Just change the layer to multiply and adjust the placement and remove the unwanted parts of the texture using the eraser tool as well, using a weak opacity of around 20-30%. Now I have here a tree branch which the background has been removed using the Magic Wand tool. I'll transfer it to the canvas that we are currently using and place it behind the model's layer and adjust until I get my desired placement. I will duplicate the layers of the branch to achieve my desired effect. I will use the polygon lasso tool to remove unwanted parts of the tree branch. Now make a new layer on top of the model and set the foreground and background color to A8, BA81, and 012955. Use the rectangular marquee tool to make a square on the picture and then go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. After applying the cloud filter, choose Filter. Then using the Paint Pocket tool, fill the rectangle with that texture. Now go to Filter, select Pixelate, and click on Mosaic, and turn the cell size into 30. After that, click on Filter, go to Distort, and click on Polar Coordinates. Make sure that you are checking rectangular to polar to achieve this kind of shape. Now, using the pen tool, I will now put out a shade for her eyes. Baby, you light up my world like nobody else. The way that you flip your hair gets me overwhelmed. But when you smile at the ground, it ain't hard to tell. After you've achieved a shape such as this one, go to the eraser tool and start removing unwanted parts to make it fit in her eye. You should be able to achieve a shape that looks like this one, and I will also replace its layer setting into multiply and lessen its opacity for a more blended effect. Now I will use a rounded brush tool with a small size with different kinds of colors to be able to put an added effect in her eye, like this one. Now let's proceed to her lips. We will roughly crease her lips using the pen tool, like so. After which, let us make a selection, and with a radius of 2, we will use the paint bucket tool to fill the lips with a teal color like this one, and change their setting to multiply and lessen the opacity to achieve a new color for her. After that, I will go to the brush tool and pick a paintbrush effect like this one. Choose the color red as the color of this brush and write across her lips. After that, I will turn the layer setting for this it to multiply and lessen the opacity as well to achieve that look. Now with the use of this pattern image, I will drag it to our current canvas and place it on top of the model to give her eye this pattern or paint effect. Remember to replace layer setting into multiply and erase unwanted parts from the world like nobody else, the way that you flip your head. Now using another paintbrush image or paintbrush effect, I will place it in our current canvas and change the layer setting into multiply and place it on your model's head for an added effect. Don't forget to always remove unwanted parts using the eraser tool and to blend it even more into our model. Now I'm using the same technique with other splatter effects of paint, of which you can all download in the link attached to this tutorial. Leave the nature effect, we will be placing this flower image in our model's forehead like so. We will be tinkering with the image brightness and the saturation to be able to achieve this yellow color. Again, use the eraser tool to erase any unwanted parts or make the image blend in even more. Now I am using the eraser tool to remove her hair around her neck. Now with other paint or splash effects, you can play around with your image by converting it into multiply mode in the layer setting and placing it on top of the model's face. Use the eraser tool to remove or reveal the model's face for an added splatter effect around her face. And that concludes our tutorial. Thank you for watching!